Maps. Oh. Fucking love maps.
Maps are pretty good.
Oh. Rafe's really going all in, isn't he?
Well, they're all concentrated around the cathedral, so that's good.
Well, yeah, it's Sunday, you heathens.
Because we are going to have that graveyard all to ourselves.
Just think of all the poetry we can write in there.
I am so going to burn my
Sully.
Ex-girlfriend.
Yeah.
Hey, listen, those were the best 3 here. Weeks of my life, Heather.
Hey, kids. Happy hunting. Nice chance to come with.
Yeah, well, unless you can find me an escalator, I think I'll pass.
All right. See you in a few.
Hey, Nate.
Yeah.
Just, just bring me back something shiny, will you?
That's the plan. Well, let's go pay our respects to Captain Avery, huh?
Scottish Cathedral. Strange place to bury your treasure, no?
I like that Nate almost looks like he's noticing the title appearing above his head.
Oh, this is where we find the grave of Henry Avery. Yeah.
Plus, with the massive bounty on his head, it's a good place to hide.
Oh, this foliage.
Mm-hmm.
This shitty Scottish foliage. It's awful. I love it.
Yeah.
So, what happened between you and Rafe?
I couldn't deal with him. I'm pretty sure he'd had enough of me. I was still coming to grips with your death and with his frustration from not finding the treasure.
It just didn't work out. I'm going to write a lot of my poems about that period.
Imagine what he want to do to you now.
Yeah. Trying not to.
Rafe, you really make me... Chafe.
He's ruthless. I mean, even more so than when we teamed up with him.
Just because you have money doesn't mean your jokes are funny.
All the more reason I don't feel bad about any of this.
My brother died and you didn't understand, but you have exclusive rights to the Scottish land.
Yeah, pretty much. Although it's been so long, it's a little hazy.
I have all rights to all of Scotland. Don't you dare try to upload Scotland to YouTube.
These crane explosives? I think stealing the cross might have made our boy Rafe a little nervous.
Yeah. Call that a DCMA, laddie. I learned my Scottish accent from Star Trek, I'm sorry.
Yeah, it must have been a shock for Avery to come here after living in the tropics for so long.
Well, I can sympathize with that.
Ah, right, because of the old prison thing.
Yeah, you have no idea how much I miss the cold.
Sully, I miss you. Sully. Come back.
So far away.
Far away. You look so small, Sully. Hey, Sully, I'm going to find a treasure. Watch this. Sully? Hey, are you watching? Sully, look. Look what I can do. Oh, he didn't see. He's not watching.
Oh. Ooh, cave treasure.
Someone's a little explosion happy.
This pig is?
Someone's a little desperate.
Who's explosion happy? You?
You know, those ancient Scots and their exploding pig figurines.
It's how they did combat.
Mm-hmm.
They would give you, they bring you presents. They're always talking about the Trojans, but man. The Scottish with their exploding pig gifts.
They couldn't put an army in there. They just shoved dynamite in the pig's rectum and hope for the best. They better accept this gift real fast. We're running out of fuse.
Oh, man.
The pig. We need to make the pigs bigger.
Get the scraping.
Yeah, that looks great.
Oh.
Right? So if you actually shoot those rocks with your gun, it'll also cause them to, like, start cascading down the hill, too. Like, it's awesome. Okay, I got an idea. The pigs can have a longer fuse if we make the fuse their coily tail.
It's a long rock.
Yeah, there you go. That's efficient.
Yeah.
We need to find another way down.
When they ask, like, why is the coily tail burning down like a fuse, you say, well, it's counting down to the prize that's inside.
It's the pig's birthday?
Yeah.
Pigs can't light candles. It's the best they can do.
Yeah.
But here we go! More skidding.
Oh, look at those rocks. Gotta stay clean.
Hey, this should hold.
Good call.
It looks like it was made for that purpose. Who else is grappling around here? Rafe?
Weird. It looks like game designers have been through here.
What the hell is all this?
It's excavation equipment.
Shoreline?
What? Look.
It says Shoreline.
I thought they were just by the cathedral.
Shit, get out!
Wait a minute. You're telling me that Rafe isn't an abject moron? That he might have some ideas in his empty rich boy head?
He may have some brains, some ideas, yeah.
Let's see. I've excavated this cathedral about 50 times in the preceding years.
Well, good. Yeah. Nice to meet you too, Shoreline. Seems like they were expecting us.
And like they're searching away from the cathedral.
Which means we should get to that graveyard pronto.
Exactly.
So in some levels, there actually are just animals chilling about.
Why didn't you guys search beyond the cathedral?
Oh, we did, a little. This place is so big, without knowing where to look, it's like shooting in the dark.
Or like blowing shit up in the dark. So you think we'll just find a tombstone that says, "Here lies Henry Avery, loving son and notorious pirate."
Yeah, I doubt it. I don't think he'd go through all that trouble to hide his tracks just to put his name on a rock.
He has many names.
Mm.
Other secret names that you do not know yet.
So, okay, first of all, very nice vista. There's a thing cut from this whole Scotland section where you're supposed to be able to, if you're standing on snow, just have a snowball fight with Sam whenever you pressed a button.
Oh, so brotherly.
Yeah.
What is this place?
The monks had several living quarters. Main one being by the graveyard, of course.
Location, location, location. More shoreline equipment.
At least no shoreliners.
Yeah, that is one of the things that did not make into the game, the snowball fight.
Well, maybe we'll get lucky and they'll blow themselves up.
All right, I understand the crates. You can put a lot of things in a crate. Mm-hmm. What's with all the barrels?
It's where they're putting all the pigs.
Oh, okay.
The pig barrels.
Got it.
Ah, my pig holder.
Ancient gravy boat, sure, sure. For Scottish Thanksgiving.
Yeah. Is that you, Sam? Excuse you.
Now, what do you bet? Yep. Dynamite.
Yeah, be careful with that stuff, huh?
Use a pig as a silencer. It's the Scottish way.
Hey, got the door open. That was...
I did it.
Very loud.
You don't say. Hopefully we just blend in with the other explosions.
They're going to know it's you, Drake, because you make explosions that sound completely different from the bad guy explosions.
Look, there's a way up through the roof. It's too high for a boost, though.
Oh, let's find something to climb on?
Yeah.
If only I could climb on literally everything. As some sort of superpower.
But yeah, Scotland's home to one other big thing that got cut from the game. There was actually going to be another set piece in Scotland that unfortunately got cut. They were apparently quite close to finishing it, but... We'll see that in a later video. The area where that would have been, at least.
Oh, okay.
There you go. Take that, door.
You're pretty good with that stuff.
Well, I've blown a lot of shit up over the years. Hey, we can use this to climb out of that building.
Can you help me push, Sam? Hello?
Hey, your idea, you're pushing.
All right. Well, I'm the only one who gets to use a dynamite, then. That's my thing. I am very good with explosives, I'll have you know, Sam. Whoops.
Whoop. You're going to want better wheels for this rough terrain. That cannot be good.
Shit. Shoreline. Hide!
Mobile cover.
Oh, yeah, there is mobile cover. If you really want to try, you can push this cover around and not get caught. It's really difficult. But it is possible to get all the way through with that crate. But yeah, we're going to take a look at a different take here to show how the enemy AI is a little different than it used to be. Again, a lot of the combat scenarios start you out in stealth, and a lot of them you can fully do in stealth, either by taking out all the dudes, or in a lot of them, just if you know where to go, just stealthing through them.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, and all the going in and out and alerts and all that. Now that it takes a little bit longer for dudes to really go into, like, full alert mode, I could just do stuff like this.
That guy should have had your number.
He was very distracted by the dead man.
Watch yourself.
You can throw dynamite. And if you're in stealth when you did that, like, they will go into alert, but they won't know where you are, so they'll actually be attracted to the area where you threw the dynamite to investigate it.
Well, that seems foolish. Mm-hmm. That seems like the last place you want to be.
Also, AI buddies in this game, pretty great now, because they can just straight up do all the stuff you do.
No.
They're actually pretty helpful, because they can... In the previous Uncharted games, you know, they wouldn't die or anything, and they could sometimes kill dudes, but... The amount of damage their guns did was really low because they had infinite ammo. Mm-hmm. That's still kind of the case with their guns, but yeah, they can stealth kill dudes for you and a bunch of other stuff. And the other thing is too, like, oh, if you get through an area without ever being caught, there's a lot less enemies. If you trigger an alert, there's a lot more guys, and speaking of that, throw some dynamite up there. Bye. So yeah, there's if you take out all the guys here and never get caught, there's only 5 dudes. If you do get caught or set off an alert by, like, doing what I did and throw dynamite, there's, like, I don't know, 12 dudes or something like that. Also, something else your AI buddies can do, they can also mark people for you if they spot them.
Bad guy.
Like so.
Sometimes it's just to, like, briefly highlight, but if your AI buddies have, like, direct line of sight with them, then they'll just, like, permanently mark them for you. It's pretty cool.
It makes Sam's a good buddy.
Yeah, it makes them feel really useful, and not just, like, dopey AI avatars that are following you.
All right. Nicely done. That could have been bad.
Yeah. Let's get out of here before anyone checks in on them.
Yeah, I only got shot like 4 times. It's fine. Color came right back.
Look, I squeeze hard enough and the bullets just shoot right back out of the wounds.
Did you have to run over the man's wrist?
There. Come on, let's go.
Look, I got a treasure to find and a brother to save. His wrist was in the way.
If anything, that's going to jam up your wheel worse than the snow.
Yeah, probably. Your crate just stops and there's just like a mangled hand all wrapped up in a wheel.
Okay, now what?
That's nice. Where I'd hide a treasure.
Sam was just coming on camera, but like, you know, if you throw dynamite and it blows up near Sam, like, he just falls flat on his ass. So if you rewind there, people watching, you will see Sam just barely come into frame, then immediately get launched back out.
I'm going to do it right now and ruin our sync. Oh, this video is going to be awful and we'll have to start over.
Got it.
Oh, careful.
Sam, we've done 18 more dangerous things just getting here. And that was just in the plane.
Shit. All right, you should never do a round of beer pong with the pilot.
Just follow me.
We learned.
Sully insisted.
For one thing, the plane's not that big. It was very cramped.
It was really hard. I mean, look, there is no seating. It was just the table.
You think you can do that? Talking about, I taught you that move.
Yeah, you were like 30 years younger.
There. You see?
That was clumsy.
It was like a 6.5 at best, Sam.
Just stare at him. Just stare him down. Who do you think you are doing that move you taught me?
I'm the jump man now. I would just love to be able to like swing too hard and just start looping around the branch.
Sam, there's a ladder just out of reach.
Hey, hold up. I'll come over.
Just hook your Gripple Bip on it.
Mm-hmm. That's
what it's for.
Gripple Bip. I have a feeling, like, with how Drake was swinging on that Drake was also one of those kids that desperately wanted to swing on the swing set so hard that he'd flip around. I tried doing that for a while. It was, like, my mission one summer.
Has anyone ever done such a thing?
I don't know.
You need, like, rocket boosters on your butt, and that's a place you do not want fire. You do not want that.
Maybe if you position your feet correctly, jet boots would work.
And that's why Paige invented them.
Yeah.
So he could swing all the way around.
There you go.
Thanks. All right, there it is. Among storm. Just a hop, skip, and a jump away.
Don't jinx us.
I can hear them partying from here.
All those monks out on the quad.
Monk house?
Here we go. Burns a little.
Huh. Those are fun.
That's the weird thing about monks. They love ultimate frisbee. I don't get it.
Do this all day.
Shh, quiet. Stop bragging. We have kill men's.
Gets colder. I'm gonna take a leak while you educate our young recruit.
Is he South African?
So what happened next? Did he put down the revolt? With
our help. So if you drop a guy straight above, you do like the double-fisted Captain Kirk punch.
Hell yes.
Cold bastards.
As Nadine says. Business is business.
You get the left.
Whatever
one.
Gets us more action.
I got right.
I could use a good coup right now.
All right. Gonna have to do better than that, fellas. Now let's see if we can keep this up.
Hey, anybody want a coup? Got a discount on coups. Our coup coupons. I'm cuckoo for coups. Please, God, just hire us.
Oh dear. Oh dear.
You two done prepping the site?
Cemetery's ready for rich boy visit.
The only people who watch the news coming out of Turkey with jealousy.
Mm-hmm.
She wants them yesterday.
Have they found anything?
But they uncovered some stuff. I don't know the details.
Can't believe General Mills sent us a cease and desist.
Oh.
Yeah, there's a gun.
These are useful.
Over here. Yeah, there's a Mettler. It's a rifle with a scope. It will two-shot dudes with body shots. It's pretty decent.
I meant the propane tank.
Oh, the propane tank. Propane tanks
can,
are also
you can
pretty
still
good.
Do that move, right?
You can. I don't do in this Hell video, yes. But you will be seeing that move a couple times throughout this LP.
Wait, what's that?
Some of my friend's bones just flew into my face.
Nothing.
Where'd those come from, those bones?
You know, probably just had really, really big fried chicken for lunch. Really big.
Also, yeah, you can mark dudes. If you're quick enough, you can mark everybody, like, in plain sight. And, like, it'll just be... You'll almost get caught, but not quite.
Hey, over here.
And again, you know, if you know how to... Where you need to go, and you're good enough, you can actually run past a lot of the dudes in these fights, not even complete the fights. Since I got a lot of dynamite, makes it fairly easy. Also, there's a magnum over here. The Barack.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So I'll just magnum my way through here.
Thanks, Obama.
Oh, three dudes. More dynamite.
Oh, shit!
Whoa! So, yeah. Combat still going on. I'm just leaving them behind. A cool thing this game does is, like, okay, clearly, you know, that's the combat area. This is another platforming area. But because I left... with guys still behind, there will now be dudes in the climbing section.
Uh-huh. Also, you left your brother behind so he can get killed again.
Sorry, Sam.
Can't help but notice. Look, that one time was an accident. It's not proof of immortality.
So yeah, if you go into otherwise just normal platforming sections of the game,
watch it over there.
While still an alert, there'll be dudes there where there normally will not be.
I found dudes. There's the dudes.
There's the dudes.
The dudes of which you spoke.
I think that's kind of cool. Just kind of blends the two like types of gameplay a little bit more together. However, yeah. if we go to this area while there's no alert up, you get this little conversation.
I nearly blew my goddamn arms off only to get chewed out by that prick. I should have popped him.
The guy's fronting our entire crew. What do you think Nadine would do to you?
I was following her order.
Still, what do you think she'd do?
Turn me inside out.
Exactly. Take some deep breaths and go walk it off.
Stroppy prick. Thinks he can tell me how to do my job.
Rafe not popular with the enlisted men, I see.
Mm-hmm.
The American shooters...
What the...
The end.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Maybe you should have popped him. The whole game would have turned out completely differently. You might not be dead.
So yeah, that style of encounter stuff goes through a lot of the game where...
Look at that view. Man.
Where you can leave dudes behind. There'll be more dudes up ahead where there normally wouldn't be. And I don't know, it's kind of nice. Mm-hmm. It's like a really minor thing, but I kind of like it.
I wonder what would happen if these people knew that they were going after treasure that Nathan Drake is also after. Would they react like they're being hunted by Jaws?
Maybe. Like,
Sam,
yeah,
this
it's,
way.
Nice.
Everybody would be trying to punch Rafe in the face just so they can get fired and go home.
Yeah, like, I feel at this point, Drake has done the things he does when you count the Vita game 4 times. Everybody, his name is probably known pretty well for being, you know, that dude who ended an entire PMC by himself, basically, yeah. With some help from his buddies.
There's a big fat file on him with, like, the U.S. intelligence services about how he ended piracy in the Pacific. They just ran out of pirates.
You know, this guy might be a force for good, or at least...
This one's looking a bit more dangerous.
All right. We're going to have a honeypot operation, but it's literally a sacred honeypot from an ancient civilization. We just put that wherever we need people to be killed.
The CIA has done dumber things in its history.
That's true.
It's better than bungee jumping.
Have you ever been bungee jumping?
No, but I'm sure this is better.
Sam really is dead. He doesn't leave a trail. Sam's a ghost.
Oh my god. Or some kind of weird vampire?
I blew the lid off it, the whole thing.
Wow.
So, this is what you've been up to all these years? Jumping around ruins?
Yeah, that and getting shot at. Blown up. Punched. Kicked.
All right, I get it.
Knifed. Drugged.
So really, I've had the much more fulfilling life. It's not hard to get in more scrapes than a person locked in a room for 15 years.
Mm-hmm.
But I count it as a moral victory. Okay. The ancient Scottish bullet vibe. Love it. Great. Got some kinky Highlanders up in here.
It's a prize that was in one of the pigs. It's like kind of like Cracker Jack, but
mountains.
Oh, and you can go there if you fly to Scotland, because it's modeled on a real mountain.
Mm-hmm.
Ugh.
that's that.
Not quite. Still gotta climb higher to cross the ravine.
I hope we're done sliding for a while. My ass is full of gravel.
I'm imagining the architect showing off this palace before it was ruins. Yeah, these pillars are going to last millennia. No one will ever tear these down. They're gonna outlive Scotland itself. Okay, how about what's on the pillars? No guarantees.
There's a dormitory gate.
I wonder what kind of hazing rituals they have.
In the monk dorm?
Yeah, in the monk dorm.
All right. This new guy, we're going to get him to chant for 10 hours a day in, get this, Latin.
Wow. Man, that's pretty rude.
Turns out he liked it, and history was never the same.
Man, maybe we should make our hazing worse? I don't know. Everybody seems to, every time somebody does it.
We make him take a vow of celibacy?
Okay.
Turns out he liked that one, too.
Ah, damn it! Monk house is too easy to get into. We gotta up our standards.
You ready for this? Stuck the landing.
Here goes nothing.
All right, you've got to hand copy these books, and the only thing you can do to pass the time is weird doodles in the margins.
All right.
Oh, and make sure the first letter of every chapter is absurdly ornate.
Okay, nobody's gonna like doing this.
He fucking loves it. Oh my god!
Son of a bitch! Well, I guess this is what we are now. All right, monk house. What kind of treasures you got? All right.
Just take the statue. Forget the thing at the feet.
Statue. Okay.
That's a hell of a treasure.
We got treasure at the statue here. What's it gonna be? Another vase? A pig?
Voldemort?
All right, Voldemort. Again, Sam. Defense against the dark arts. You gotta be ready. Do you have like a really, really happy thought they can bring up on command? Because you're kind of gonna need that.
This is a castle in Scotland. Is this what Hogwarts looks like to Muggles?
Maybe.
Did we find it?
Oh my god.
Come on. We're here.
Yes, we are. Jesus. Wait, look at this place.
Welcome to the St. Dismas Dormitory. Pledge final resting place of one Henry Avery.
Let's find that grave. Hey, Nathan, check it out. This one's got a pair of cutlasses. It's like the scroll from the cross.
The dates aren't right.
Well, one down and a hell of a lot to go.
All right. We got Nate's journal back. So it's time to take a look through his journal.
I'm not patient enough for this.
Nate does not like drawing Celtic knots. He tried.
Yeah.
5-6 times. Kind of gave up. He's good at drawing skulls, though. Henry's gravery.
It needs to have treasure. Dear God, it needs to have treasure.
Please tell me there's treasure there. All right, let's flip to the start from the beginning. We still got that letter from, 15 years ago. From the beginning of the game.
You gotta keep good files from your treasure hunts.
Yeah, you gotta be orderly. Be organized.
Useful Italian phrases.
There must be a beginning of any great matter.
Those are all correct as far... Yep.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I would expect them to be.
Mm-hmm. Do you have a boyfriend? I like that one's in cursive.
It makes me think someone else wrote it.
Maybe Sam. Maybe Sam wrote that one. Again, that NeoGAF post with the cross. Drake, you should know about the Honor Among Thieves thing already. Your second game was named after that.
Oh, good. He gave us the play-by-play with Telestrator action.
Ibuprofen for dinner.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the next page. You know, Nate just likes to keep clippings about the people he really doesn't like right now.
Sure. I can't believe that Rafe is spoiling his family name. Grandma Irene would be so disappointed.
So yeah, Rafe is the rich dude who still wants to do things himself for the recognition of it, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, Shoreline is supposed to be like South African, I think.
Oh, well, there you go.
I think it is actually supposed to be that, yeah.
The accent makes a lot of sense.
Yeah. Also, another thing that kind of carried over from Nate's previous journals is that he really likes having pressed plants and flowers taped everywhere. I think this is the first page that has it, but he starts going crazy with the pressed flowers really quick. Basically, the second he gets to Scotland, he's just ripping every little bit of foliage he can.
And now we're back to the present. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Cross cutlasses, skull and crossbones, and the date 1659 to 1699. We find a tombstone with all three, and we're in business. Well,
that one's got one.
Let's desecrate some graves. Let's.
That one's got one.
Lord McMahon, Vince McMahon.
Look at this one. Tempus edax rerum.
Time devours all things.
Jeez, cherry bunch of folks we got here.
It was me, Austin, devouring all things all along.
Oh, rest in peace, McMahon.
Cross swords, but no skull and crossbones here.
All right, so aside from having a look for
I'm pretty sure it's not going to be here.
Yeah, aside from looking for the right grave, there's also this little thing over here that, so journal entries just aren't automatic. Like, there's a lot of automatic ones, but there's also extra ones that count as collectibles.
Ooh.
It's like Rafe's been digging around already.
Great.
Good thing he has no idea what he's actually looking for.
No, but he could get lucky.
Well, let's hope not.
So yeah, there's lots of things he can look at, and Nate'll draw them.
This is going to turn into the plot of the Minesweeper movie, I can tell.
Again, more pressed flowers already.
When did you even get those?
I don't know.
So fast.
I don't know, really fast. So yeah, there's a lot of extra things he can look at that Nate will draw. There's some pretty cute ones later on. But anyways, looking for the grave. If you take too long, Sam will eventually find it.
Well, we can't have that.
But it's like, you know, if you just sit still for like, you know, or don't find it for like 10 minutes, that's when he'll do it.
No swords. Oh, this isn't it.
And Jarvis isn't Avery at all. They're completely different names.
Some of the letters are the same, but
just can't make that anagram work.
Yeah. If we observe this one.
Ooh, the swords match. Let's see. Nope. Bad dates.
There's your next Indiana Jones reference. Yeah. The bad dates.
Date is correct, but the swords are upside down. Wrong one.
Rest in peace, that monkey that ate those bad dates. And also, if you just sit around a bunch, Sam will just start cracking wise about more of the tombstones.
Can always rely on Sam for a bit of levity.
Yeah.
Check this one out. Here lies infamous Captain Tripp. Got drunk one night and fell off his ship. Hey, okay, I just made that one up.
Yeah. Mom always said I was the funny one.
Get your jokes historically accurate, Sam. They would have just done a sea funeral.
You should have said it when we were getting off the plane. There's water there.
Dang it, Sam.
Sam.
No skull and crossbones. Nice Celtic cross. Not the grave we want, though.
I wish Sully would, like, pipe in over the walkie-talkie there just to say, like, that was crap. It sucks, Sam. I'm calling you out.
What is he doing on that plane? Playing a lot of solitaire?
Yeah, well, swords are a match. So is the year. Sam, come here.
What'd you find it?
Benjamin Bridgman.
That's Avery's alias.
Something odd about this skull, though. It's like it doesn't belong to the stone.
I mean, what's odd about it is that's not Avery's sigil.
Huh. Yeah, I mean, the skull should be facing... sideways.
Whoop! Oh, trick skull.
My God. You ready for this?
Oh, I've been ready for a long time.
Rafe, you fucking moron. You had 15 years.
Let's see what we got.
Oh, this is just the place where they did the hazing rituals. Damn it.
Nothing here but a bunch of quills and nothing. It's just quills.
It's a crypt.
A crypt hidden behind a secret door?
I assume the secret door was added afterwards.
To hide his loot.
Well, fingers crossed.
Also, yeah, if you do shine your flashlight right in his face.
Yeah.
He doesn't like that.
Desecration. Desecration. Come on.
Whoop. Sam, what, how do you like this light in your eye? No? You don't like that? All right.
It looks like he wishes he was back in Panama.
God, my fucking brother. I haven't seen him for 15 years, and he still shines this light in my eyes all the time. Stop it. Punch you in the shoulder.
Oh, somebody else journals.
One of the old monks wrote this.
Ah, look. That nice capital letter. A nice A.
Mm-hmm. He did this one in a hurry.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, this one's just about, like, oh, man, we're going to have to give up the castle grounds.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to lose Monk House.
And, oh, no.
Oh, no. Monk House is going to get shut down. And then Avery just happened to come by with a shitload of pirate money.
Hell yeah.
Just went like, hey.
Avery won the karaoke competition and he saved the rec center.
And... yeah, Avery's just like, you know, I'll just buy this off you. So you don't have to give it back. You'll get money to settle down a monk house somewhere else.
Mm-hmm.
And also he was like, hey, I have a shitload of dead people I need to bury. Thanks.
No questions asked.
Sam, would you want to join Monk House? Like if we, you know, let's say we brought it back.
Well, I think Nate would want to put Sam in there just for the vow of silence. Ayo,
hey,
waka waka.
No more jokes.
Hey, she's embarrassed by what I said. All right.
She's just stuck like that. Didn't I pick you up in an earlier game or something?
Hey, I got a quarter slug if you want to get part of a Coke.
Whoa. Gang's all here. Jesus. Dismas on the left.
Penitent thief.
Guest is on the right.
Jerk thief.
Yeah, he was an asshole. All right. Up high.
Avery sure had a thing for St. Dismas, huh?
Well, Avery fancied himself a good thief, right? Only plundered and murdered the non-British heathens.
Guess that's what passed for good back then.
Good enough.
Some things never change.
Let's peep this...
Whoa.
Let's peep this Jesus drawing.
What are you trying to do? Find the rings of Saturn? Come on now.
Jesus, in parentheses, Jesus. Jesus, occupation? Jesus. Man, I wonder how many times Drake has had to practice. Well, I don't know. Maybe he really did just draw Jesus for the first time there.
You think he's drawn a lot of Jesuses in his day?
Yeah.
He's certainly got a lot of practice figure drawing. And yeah. I think if you can draw an average human man, you can draw a Jesus.
Yeah, you could probably draw a Jesus.
Is this a door? Looks like a door.
It's a puzzle, Nate.
I don't see a way to open it, though.
It's a puzzle, Sam.
What are these star symbols?
They're a puzzle, Drakes.
Okay, Sam's been, you know, behind bars for 15 years, so I can excuse that. Drake's only been out of doing the puzzles for, like, two or 3 years.
Hey, Smokey. Need your lighter over here.
You know, that hurts my feelings.
Not as much as it hurts your lungs.
Thank you, Father Duffy.
Isn't that something?
The light's coming from the other side of the wall.
Let's shove some heavy things.
Let's see here.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you can rotate them.
I can aim the lights. I am loving this. Hey, here
I am loving puzzles, Nate.
Oh, not quite.
Puzzles,
yeah,
Nate.
Those two. Those two.
Yeah.
That looks right.
Whoop. Now rotate the Jesus lights.
Oh, connect the dots.
Sam's saying that because he's literally got to connect the dots book with him.
I think you got that one.
He and Silly rock, paper, scissored for it. Hey, kid, I got to do something on this plane.
Sully already went through all of his crossword books.
That's it, you got it.
He found, like, the only dirty crossword book. Almost every clue is a different four-letter word. They're very small puzzles.
It looks like a constellation.
Yeah. That's Libra. The scales of justice.
That's an interesting choice for a bunch of pirates.
Well, this one's ass again.
Cheeks. Wait, this is strangely themed.
But why did Avery choose this sign? Huh, Sam? Sam?
Should have been Bootes, because they got all that pirate booty.
Oh.
Okay, let's give this a shot.
Open sesame.
Own treasure.
Shush. Well, nice view. No treasure, though.
No, but look, you see those crosses?
Yeah. Hey, is that a cave right below?
Yeah, I think Avery's trying to tell us where to go next. There's one problem, though. Going back that way means we have to go back toward the cathedral.
And back towards Rafe.
Yeah, Rafe doesn't seem so stupid now, does he?
Let's not keep him waiting.
Hopefully he's just right outside so I can just pop him in the face real quick. Make this real easy.
Then Nadine's going to turn you inside out.
Oh, man.
Throw the Voldemort skull at him. He will flip out.
Okay, I have a Voldemort skull and I have a Voldo knife. I feel like I need one more V thing and I'll be good to go.
You got a vibrator. So.
Oh, yeah, actually.
You're covered. The perfect distraction, the three V's.
Shit. They opened the gate up there. Good, because that's the way we gotta go. I follow my lead.
I think you can throw dynamite that far.
Yeah, maybe.
The storm's been messing with the radios. If we don't get back from them soon, I'll go check in.
Hup. You can still grab dudes from ledges.
Yeah, that's what you get for wearing a belt.
Should not be standing by a window, dude. That's a dangerous thing.
Oh, yes. Every time.
Windows are a bad thing to be directly underneath when Drake is around. Whoop.
Look out! Dynamite!
Don't run, just crouch and point. Down there! You know, I'm crouching so you know it's on the ground.
There's a lot of training for pointing out dynamite, but it was really bad training. Oh yeah, your AI buddies can sometimes just grab dudes and hold them for you, and that turns into a one-hit kill for you.
Nice.
Yeah. Doesn't matter how beefy they are.
I think Sam is forgetting that this is a cover shooter.
Yeah, Sam likes to hang out in the open. This area is a little scary to hang out around because the dude... People like to be directly below you when you're on this wall. The AI likes to go there a lot. Oh.
You don't know how lucky you are, my friend.
That death could have been 10 times as painful and humiliating. Okay, look, I'll make up for it with this guy. Oh!
Shit!
Yeah, you made it! Thanks.
Dropkick. Also good.
Also good. When you have AI buddies, there's also a lot more, because the AI buddies are a lot more directly involved in the combat now. There's a lot more lines between Nate and your AI buddies, like, complimenting each other on quick killings.
Well, that's good. You know, that's how a family stays together.
Okay. I think we're clear.
Well, that could have gone better.
We're still breathing. That's good enough.
Let's just get that gate open.
Okay, but I'm taking my gun.
I'm taking this guy's gun, Sam. Goodbye.